If I live to be 100, I'll never forget the year of the global pandemic. Cases rose and, well, you might not believe it, but the world almost missed Christmas. You know, I don't know what we would have done without the help of Paxton to help Santa Claus. Anyway, what? Are you saying that some of you are not acquainted with the story of Paxton? Wow, pull up an ottoman and lend an ear. You know, it started one Christmas Eve not very long ago.
It was Christmas time and everyone was happy. Everyone except one of our special friends.
Go away!
Merry Christmas, Oscar.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Can you read the sign, huh? I hate Christmas!
Don't say that, Oscar. It's Christmas Eve. It's the night where Santa Claus comes and he takes his big bag of toys and slides down the chimney.
Just hold it right there, bird brain. Now, because of the pandemic, we can't have any of our friends and family over for Christmas Eve dinner, eh? So, how can a guy like Santa Claus, who's a complete stranger, how do you suppose it's even legal for him to break guidelines and come into everyone's homes, potentially spreading the virus to every house he goes to, eh?
Well, gee, Oscar, I never thought about it like that before.
Yeah, I bet you haven't. But if I were you, I'd start soon and give me an answer. Because if we don't find out, there'll be a lot of empty stockings around town tomorrow morning. Merry Christmas.
Now, you see, our new friend Paxton had a very serious problem. And so, he went home and put some thought into it.
Okay. Well, maybe if I watch the news, it'll give me an answer.
I have some bad news. It seems as cases are an extreme uptick, it looks like Christmas will just have to be canceled.
Oh no. Wait a minute. I know what I have to do to save Christmas.
And so Paxton packed his bags and traveled by map, which is the easiest and safest way to travel. And soon, he arrived at his destination, the North Pole.
Oh, well, hi there. Hey, hi yourself. I was here to see, Mr. Santa Claus.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, but, you know, with Christmas being canceled and all, Mr. Claus isn't seeing anyone tonight.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas.
I wish I could be Santa Claus for just one day. I'd fill a bag with kindness and give it all away. I'd make the world a better place. I'd do that if I could. I love the way it feels inside when I do something good.
You wish you could be Santa Claus. Perhaps you can. The job's about the giving, not the suit and not the man. It's all about the caring and the part that we can play. It's spreading joy and peace on earth
and love on Christmas Day.
Santa, oh, I'm so glad to see you. I have a few things here. I have some masks and some hand sanitizer to help you tonight.
special.
I know we can do this, Santa. There are millions of kids counting on you.
Wow, Paxton, thank you. You know, you gave me hope. Christmas is not canceled. It's going to take a little longer, but I think we can do this. Paxton, with your faith and knowledge so bright, will you help me deliver Christmas safely tonight?
Really? It would be an honor, sir.
Oh, good. Maybe I should keep you in mind each year. You know, it's people like you that make me feel a whole lot better about human nature. We best be on our way.
And so, Santa, with the help of Paxton and his knowledge of CDC guidelines, went to the roofs of every house around the world and brought presents to all the good little boys and girls. Just as they were about to head back to the North Pole, Paxton remembered that he had something to do.
Hey, what's the big idea, huh? No, what is it? Oh, so that's how he does it, huh? Dropping from the sky. Well, let's see what I got here. Oh, it's trash!
And so, that is the story of Paxton, and how he helped bring Christmas to all the good little boys and girls all around the world. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year!